These tiger stripes are produced by the gravity of Saturn in the southern polar region of Enceladus. And because of the tidal forces, sometimes are pulling it apart, sometimes pushing it together, sometimes slipping it past each other. And when it pulls it apart or when it slips past, it allows the material underneath, which is being heated by all of these tidal stresses and flexing on it, allows those geysers to eject water and material from underneath the surface of Enceladus. This is another way of looking at it, the fault, the parallel faults, and this is showing the vertical displacement to give you an idea of the elevation of the displacement of these sort of, they look like fault lines. Look at every different kind of diagram that you can find that has been put out to study these things, because you don't know, you might get something like this and ask a question about it. So don't just go for one or two things. Find as many diagrams that portray the movement that would cause water to move, and study that. Iapetus is really an odd moon. It has this very dark areas and it has these very bright areas. Now Iapetus is locked in synchronous rotation. It orbits very, very slowly. It's in with all these other moons of Saturn. It is thought that the dust and ice from all of those moons kind of settles down in the equatorial region of Iapetus, and then when it does get to a position where it's getting some radiation, the radiation warms that darker material, warms it up, causes the icy parts to sublimate. They settle down further away in the polar regions, and so it keeps the dark areas keep getting darker and darker, and the light areas keep getting brighter and brighter. And it also has this bizarre ridge, which circles the entire planet. I'll get to in just a second. Here is the transitional zone from the bright areas to the darker areas. And if I were you, I would look at that transition zone and study the difference between where things settle and where they're sublimating all the time. Here is the wall, which that strange thing is. It circles the entire planet. This object used to rotate a lot faster, and so it had that oblique shape to it, so that it was wider in the equatorial region than in the polar region. And then this formed as it started rotating slower and slower and was no longer able to contain that shape. Or did this moon of Saturn used to have its own ring of material around it, and it all collapsed onto the surface of the moon? So any of those is possible. Titan, of course, always famous for the only moon in the solar system that has a very thick atmosphere. It has a very thick hydrocarbon atmosphere, actually. And it is thought that underneath it has a decoupled icy shell. It has a global subsurface ocean beneath that, and then it has another high-pressure icy area below that before you get to the silicate core. So, and this is a place where, you know, here's an artistic illustration. It is always thought that on Titan, methane exists in the same way that water exists here on the planet Earth. Here on Earth, water exists at its triple point. It can exist as a liquid, as a gas, or as a solid. And maybe that's what's happening on Titan, but with methane. So you have methane clouds, methane rain, methane lakes, methane ice. But it has a high hydrocarbon content. And we actually know what the surface looks like, because we had the Cassini mission, went to Saturn and studied Saturn and its moons. And part of that mission was the Huygens probe, which was ejected down in through the atmosphere to the surface of Titan. So this is an actual raw image of what the surface of Titan looks like. And this is one of the few images. Of course, the didn't last too long before it died, but before it did send out some images of the surface. And here you can see on the surface that there are drainage, moon-wide drainage patterns. You can see the edges of channels, you can see flow patterns, and so it does very much look like some kind of liquid does run across the surface of Titan. And here is an elevation map of the surface of Titan so far. If you find anything that shows any more additional information, for you should study it and add it to your repertoire, your archive of data to study for this particular event.